followed by the Dean and Vic, Professor Chidi, and Deshiji, followed by the Dean of Arts, Professor A.A. Adeoye. We have the Dean Basic Digital Sciences, Professor Piju. Dean Basic Medical Sciences, Professor Latuji. Dean Communication and Information Sciences, Professor Jimo. Dean of Education, Professor Olafsanke Williams. Dean of Engineering and Technology, we have Professor A.A. Jimo. Dean Environmental, Dr. Mako. Dean of Law, Professor Jaya. Dean of Biosciences, Professor Fatoba. Dean of Management Sciences, Professor M.A. Jaya. Acting Dean of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Dr. Mali. Followed by the Dean of Physical Sciences. And we have the Dean of Students and Peers, represented by Mr. Dean, Dr. Alex Akumi. We have the Provost College of Health Sciences, the University Librarian, the University Registrar, the DVC RTI, the DVC Management Sciences, the DVC Academic, inaugural lecturer of today, Professor Baba Abdullahi Alafara. And of course, the Vice Chancellor, Professor Suleiman Agen Abdulkarim. Services, Professor P.F. Sule, MC Vice Chancellor of Research, Technology and Innovation, Professor Khalil Olajinka Buhari. The Registrar of the University will be represented by the DR Senate, Mr. Adams. The University Librarian, Professor Abdulwahab Olariwaju Isa. The Provost College of Health Sciences, Professor Olariwaju Adedun. The inaugural lecturer of today, Professor Papa Abdullahi Alafara. The Dean of Student Affairs, represented by the Sub-Dean, Dr. Alex Akobu. Deans of various faculties here present. Directors of various directorates and units here present. Distinguished professors here present. And traditional rulers here present. The university scholars here present. Staff and students of the Nairobi Fine University here present. And virtually present. Friends of the university. Distinguished members of the press, ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome to the 198th in the series of inaugural lectures of the University of Nairobi. Mr. Vice Chancellor, the 198th in the series of inaugural lectures of this university is the 50th from the Faculty of Science, Live and Physical combined, and the second from the Department of Industrial Chemistry. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the 198th in the series of inaugural lectures of this university have been entitled Sustainable National Development, Mineral and Material Resources to the Rescue. And it is to be delivered by a distinguished professor of analytical and industrial material chemistry, Professor Bamba Abdullahi Alafara. It's over to you, Mr. Vice Chancellor.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I know Professor Alafara has some Christian friends. I say a very big evening to all of you. I'm going to start with an appeal. When we had the idea of continuing our inaugural lectures, we were told by those who came to this auditorium that ideally we should not have more than 100 people in the audience. And I remember striking an agreement with my brother, Professor Laro, if he's in the crowd. We said we are going to limit the attendance inside the auditorium to 50, maximum 100. And that we are going to make provision that we in the University of Ilorin has, that no other university in Nigeria presently has. And that is to make virtual provision so that it can be seen anywhere in the world. Now, after Professor Alaro's delivery, I had to bend a little because a gentle boy came to me and said, "Oh God, why not let's make it 200? And I agreed, okay, let's put it at 200. But you agree with me that we are more than 200 here. The issue is that it is not alarming yet, but we have to be mindful that it is a new life that we all must live. So it's an appeal. We want everybody to be able to witness the great thing that our brother is doing today. But we don't want to do it at a risk to our lives. So I'm going to appeal to you. If next time you are being asked to go and look at where they are seeing it virtually, or you can even stay at home. All you need is probably to buy data for I don't know how much, because I'm using university benefit. So let me not. But the issue is, wherever you are, you can see the same thing and get it even recorded. So on that basis, I welcome you all to today's delivery by Professor Baba Abdullahi Alafara, who is standing before you. Professor Baba Abdullahi Alafara was born on the 3rd of March, 1968. In Ilorin, to the family of Alhaji and Alhaja, to Harry Amin Baba Alafara from Olowuru, Olowuru, Megida Ward in Ifeanyi, district of Moro local government area of Kwara State. He attended Alore LSMB Ilorin, Kwara State from 1982 to 1987. He got his Nigeria Certificate in Education, NCE, in Mathematics and Chemistry from the Kwara State College of Education, Ilorin, from 1988 to 1991. He attended University of Ilorin from 1991 and graduated with a bachelor's degree in chemistry education in the year 1995. He obtained his master's degree in chemistry in 2002 and his PhD in chemistry still from the same university in 2008. Can I have some applause, please? Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Professor Baba Abdullahi Alafara joined the services of the University of Ilorin as an assistant lecturer in the Department of Chemistry on 4th July 2002. He rose to become a professor of analytical, industrial, and materials chemistry on the 4th of October 2017. Professor Baba Abdullahi Alafara has a detailed administrative experience, which includes being the head of the Department of Chemistry between 2017 and 2020. Associate Editor of Nigerian Journal of Material Science and Technology, Society of Nigeria, since 2017, the date. He was Service Coordinator in the Department of Industrial Chemistry from 2014 to 2015, and was recently appointed in the Extraction and Processing Division, EPD, Council, as the education representative of the Minerals and Materials Society, TMS, in USA for a term of 3 years. Professor Baba Abdullahi Alafara attended trainings and conferences in Nigeria and abroad, and he has a wide range of publications to his credit. He's happily married to Alhaja Mariam Akewusola Alafara, and they are blessed with 5 children. Standing before you today, I present to you the inaugural lecturer of today, Professor Abdullahi Baba Alafara.
Bismillah Rahman Rahim. The Vice Chancellor, the Deputy Vice Chancellors, Academic, Management Services, Research, Technology and Innovation, the Registrar, the Bursa, the University Librarian, the Provost College of Health Sciences, Dean Faculty of School Sciences, Dean of other faculties, Postgraduate School and Student Affairs, Professors and other members of the Senate, Chairman and members of the Governing Council, Directors of various units, Head Department of Industrial Chemistry, heads of other departments and units, members of the academic and non-teaching staff, my lords, preacher and temporal, members of my nuclear and extended families, distinguished students of Industrial Chemistry and Chemistry departments, distinguished invited guests, gentlemen of the print and electronic media, greatest uni laureates, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, indeed, all praises and adoration are due to Allah the Almighty and the Lord of the worlds. I sincerely thank him for sparing my life from the day of my birth to date. I am immensely grateful to Allah for making it possible for me to stand before you all today to deliver the 198th edition of the inaugural lecture series of the University of Ilorin, the Better by Far University. Today's inaugural lecture is unique as it is the first of its kind in the university from the Department of Industrial Chemistry of this university. I want to appreciate the great opportunity afforded me by the University of Ilorin administration under our dynamic and hardworking Vice Chancellor, Professor Sulaiman Age Abdulkarim, to present today's inaugural lecture. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, please permit me to inform the respected audience present here today to present a brief history of my early life prior to joining the academics. Some over 45 years ago, before my primary education at Ado Local School Management Board in 1976, my late grandfather, Mola Maminu Alafara, the Mogaji Alafara, popularly called Babagba, a farmer who used to assist in his farming activities, saw traces of brilliancy in me and would often call me Omotolo Juna. This served as a strong motivation for me to brilliantly excel in my studies, which culminated in what is being celebrated today. Due to his foresight, he felt as he discontinued farming with him in the village at Soro, Ilu Yayo, near Kisi, Oyo State, and Olowaru, Ipaye District, Moro Local Government Area of Kwara State. He therefore decided to bring me back to my parents, who in turn handed me over to my respected uncle, late Alhaji Anabilowiri, a renowned printer in Ilorin in the 1970s, who eventually nurtured me. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, that was Alhaji Lowori and my late mom during my companionship as Odo Adini Anabiloni Gamos, Kuntu Ilorin, in the year 2000. May Allah grant him a generous Fidaus. I must appreciate my paternal grandmother, late Akia Umul Hairi Aminu Alapara, popularly known as Ye Ileku, who also migrated with me to the family house at Alapara Compound, Alore Ilorin, in order to guide and monitor our grandson, who is standing before you today. May the Almighty Allah be pleased with them in a generous Fidaus. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, I began my primary education cum apprentice as a printer trainee with my uncle in 1976. It is a norm every day to carry out house chores extensively, including recitation of the Al-Quran and Oki Eguru, a local delicacy made from beans, for my late grandfather, mother, daily after school. In addition to attending evening Islamic lesson at Ile Alhaji Adore Ilorin, I did all of this as a routine from the primary school at Adore LSMB to my secondary school days at Mount Carmel College, College of Education in Ilorin, and as an undergraduate at the University of Ilorin. After my wife's examination at Mount Carmel College, my initial aim was to study medicine in the university. But for the delay in the release of my WAEC results in 1987, this development made me to switch to chemistry with the intention of working in the petrochemical industry. This probably was due to a Lambert chemistry textbook I inherited from my cousin, Mr. Abdulghani Suleiman Alafara. In essence, distinguished audience, ladies and gentlemen, who could have imagined that the boy, popularly called Omoyelekun in those days, could be standing before you today as a professor to present an inaugural lecture? Indeed, immeasurable thanks are due to Allah for this unique opportunity. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Today's inaugural lecture, entitled Sustainable National Development, Mineral and Material Resources to the Rescue, was actually inspired by the deep understanding of the analytical and material chemistry derived from my mentors, Professor F.A. Adekola and M.A. Mesudi, during my second degree research at the Department of Chemistry, University of Ilorin. My first degree in chemistry education from the then Department of Curriculum Study and Education Technology, Faculty of Education, University of Ilorin, where its chemistry curriculum is laced with skills offered in the Bachelor of Science and Education degree program, further strengthening me as a university teacher and even as an analytical and material chemist. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, chemistry as a central science, due to its relevance to all fields of human endeavors, draws on the ideas and techniques of analytical chemistry, according to Adekola 2013. Thus, analytical chemistry is a branch of chemistry that deals with qualitative and qualitative analysis. From the understanding of the above, determine the array or compositional evaluation of the substance for the design and synthesis for industrial value addition satisfying the established condition is referred to as material chemistry. The design and synthesis or preparation of an industrial product involves the following analytical procedure for necessary prediction of its purity level and product acceptability. Thus, the application of the aforementioned analytical procedure covering both the physical and chemical properties toward the transformation of raw material into product for solving societal and human problems is termed industrial chemistry. No doubt, the transformer of the defined raw materials to finished products of industrial value are human beings, including scientists whom analysts created by the Almighty Allah from clay, a unique mineral, as supported by Quran 23 verse 12, Surah Al-Mu'minin, Walakadi Alakina Linzanu, Fisula Lati Mintin. And certainly, did we create man from an extract of clay? Also from Quran 15 verse 26, Surah Al-Hijri. And he did certainly create man out of clay from an altar black mud. Also in the wise world of Hindu scientists, it is believed that God sleeps in the mineral, awakens in plants, walks in animal, and thinks in man. These citations led credence to the contemporary understanding that any beneficiated product of different kinds is made up of materials, including minerals with specific properties. Thus, mineral is a naturally occurring inorganic substance or material with a definite chemical composition and ordered internal structure formed as a result of geological processes. Minerals with specific values on earth are God-created materials with the same property that make their uses to differ from each other. Nigeria, for example, is naturally endowed with different mineral resources and is one of the richest countries of the world as far as mineral resources are concerned. All the 36 states of the country, including the Federal Capital Territory, are richly endowed with diverse economic minerals or proven reserves that can adequately support the country's growth and development. Economic minerals of industrial values with high proven reserves in Nigeria include sphalerite, galena, chalcobarite, ilmenite, gold, carbonite, iron ore, siderite, and pyrocyte, among others. In general, there are over 40 different types of minerals spread across the nation in diverse environments, and the various mineral resources are categorized into strategic groups as iron, non-ferrous industrial metals, precious metal, and industrial minerals. Out of these minerals, several strategic minerals, including coal, bitumen, limestone, iron ore, barite, gold, lead, zinc, ore, were identified by the Nigerian Ministry of Mines and Steel Development for aggressive reform to encourage investment in the sector, as mining was a significant driver of Nigeria economy and industrialization before the oil boom. For example, deposits of lead and zinc ores used for automotive batteries, tires, basic chemicals, galvanized sheets, and so on, which are usually found as mixtures, have not been low in Nigeria, but they have only been mined in the past on a very small scale. The Nigerian lead zinc field extends from about 560 kilometers in a narrow belt from Ishiagu in Ebonyi State. The estimate of workable iron ore deposits useful for steel and other production, which stand in excess of 2.5 billion tons, are found in Itape. However, Agbaja iron ore deposit proving reserve of about 1 billion metric tons is the largest in Nigeria. Though its high phosphorus that range between 1.4 to 2% and low silicon modulus and fine grain texture constitute a major problem for utilization in the blast furnace or direct reduction process. Cassiterite, the principal source of tin, is used for corrosion prevention and component of some important alloys, such as salt, solder, and bronze. In the early 1900s, Nigeria was well known in the tin mining and was the second tin producing country in the world after Russia. However, because of more attention was paid to crude oil, Nigeria is currently in the 13th position globally and ranked third in Africa with an estimation of 570 metric tons after Congo, DR, and Rwanda. In fact, by the end of World War II, the four largest tin producing countries produced over 80% of the world tin. Like Nigeria in 1986, for example, the portion of production from the four largest producers declined to about 55%, while the price of the tin rose from about 1,500 to 18,000 US dollar per metric ton. In response to tin shortage during the World War II to date, the United States began stockpiling refined tin metal to ensure a strategic supply in the event of another war, God forbid. Kwara State, created on 27th of May, is blessed with the following abundant mineral resources. We can have marbudia, granite, clay, kaolin, feldspar, gold, mica, rutile, ilmenite, and so on. Table 1 summarizes the solid minerals and their locations across the local government areas of Kwara State. The Nigerian economy is ranked the largest in Africa and the 30th in the world, with a gross domestic product GDP of approximately $400 billion in 2018, with four dominant sectors: agriculture, oil and gas, mining, manufacturing and services. Nigeria is highly populated emerging markets with rapid growing manufacturing and services sector. Unfortunately, the economy is still very monolithic and dependent on the oil and gas. Oil and gas sector, which contributes about 40% of the nominal GDP and over 90% of export earnings and 75% of gross revenue. As revenue from crude oil has declined sharply in recent years, Nigeria has struggled and is still struggling to find other revenue sources through energizing of the other sector of the economy. Therefore, exploitation of the abundant mineral resources is a prominent source of diversifying the economic base of the country. Efforts are currently ongoing to tap the available mineral resources as the basis for industrial growth and national economic development. All hands must therefore be on deck to optimize the extraction and utilization of these abundant natural metals. Hence, there is need to develop or continuously develop simple, feasible, and cost-effective, as well as eco-friendly routes for the extraction of metals for industrial value addition from the nation's economic mineral deposit and material resources become most paramount. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, considering the past deposit and availability of the aforementioned solid mineral resources in Kwara State and other states of the Federation, the potential of harnessing these abundant mineral resources for export and use in domestic industry for generation of foreign exchange and internal revenue, respectively, has not been given the deserved attention. It is important to note that Nigerian minerals have high economic value, and most companies in Nigeria and other parts of the world depend largely on the importation of the refined metal products extracted from their metal ore bodies. Consequently, the use of locally sourced minerals for our industry will enable the country to save a significant proportion of its hard-earned foreign currencies, as there are increasing demand for industrial metal products. At present, the hydrometallurgical processing or improvement on the quality of Nigerian minerals has not been given serious consideration. However, the federal government of Nigeria is now addressing positively the solid mineral sector, owing to economic recession arising from a drop in the price of crude oil, coupled with the desire to diversify Nigeria's economy. The data from today's inaugural lecture, if fully utilized, will no doubt open a new fulfilling chapter in Nigeria's economic growth and development. Techniques of minerals and material processing. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, till date, the extraction of metal from ores is carried out either by pyrometallurgy or hydrometallurgy. Pyrometallurgy encompasses the traditional high temperature processes of roasting, smelting, converting, and refining. It involves high energy consumption with emission of obnoxious gases such as SO2 and is used to produce the bulk of non-ferrous metals from high-grade ores. As historical reports have shown, people have planned to construct furnaces and use fire to melt rock and extract metal thousands of years ago. Compared to pyrometallurgy, hydrometallurgy is a relatively recent development that involves the use of water and aqueous solution in place of dry, high-temperature methods for processing ores. Hydrometallurgy is essentially concerned with metals whereby metal salts or other metal compounds are produced by means of chemical reactions involving aqueous and organic solutions. It operates in the temperature range of 25 to 250 degrees centigrade. The intrinsic nature of chlorine-rich liquids resulting from the hydrological treatment of sulfured minerals ore is rather complex. For example, these solutions usually contain relatively high concentration of basic metals, as well as a small content of other rare metals, frequently precious metals. Therefore, for separation and purification of these valuable elements, prior to appropriate beneficiation is just adding value to whatever product that we are getting. The application of sulfur extraction procedure is most essentially considered due to economic and safety reasons. Detailed characterization of the selected residue using some defined instrumentation are required at different heating states for assessing the dissolved and undissolved species to better understand the dissolution kinetic mechanism and for predicting optimal extraction conditions. Some of the techniques that could be used in selected product analysis and characterization during leaching and some extraction processes include X-ray fluorescence, X-ray diffraction, atomic absorption spectrophotometry, atomic emission, optical emission spectrophotometry for aqueous metal concentration analysis, FPIR for functional group characterization, as well as a scanning EDS for decomposition and surface morphology, among others. It is painful to note that many of our laboratories in Nigerian universities today, cannot host any serious research from beginning to completion. Why? Due to lack of aforementioned state of the art equipment. For instance, many of our postgraduate student samples are normally packaged and sent to countries like the United Kingdom, Saudi Arabia, USA, and South Africa for analysis. It is, however, not strange to find lecturers contributing money from their meager salary towards completion of student projects for meeting defined needs. The dissolution rate of solid minerals and materials using shrinking core model is based on the assumption that the material is a homogeneous spherical particle. It provides important information on the mechanism of dissolution of solid material in a given medium. Some of the currently used shrinking core models for better understanding of mineral dissolution routes and prediction are summarized from equations 1 to 3. My contribution to hydrometallurgical research for economic development. From August 2001 to July 2008, I successfully defended my MSc and PhD degree dissertation entitled Extraction of Zinc from Sphalerite Mineral Deposit and Recovery of Zinc and Lead from Sphalerite Galena and Waste Material by Hydrometallurgical Process, respectively, at the Department of Chemistry of this great citadel of learning. Besides, my other research experiences include 1 year postdoctoral research on leaching of some Nigerian minerals at the CSIR, Institute of Minerals and Material Technology, Bhubaneswar, India, and deep knowledge gained from wide areas of active participation at many research workshops, seminars, exhibitions, and conferences in Nigeria and different parts of the globe. This background has equipped me to be prolific as an authority and a renowned scholar in hydrometallurgical research in minerals and material processing. With H index and IK index of 20 and 30 respectively, and more than 1,100 citations and still counting on daily basis, my research output has been widely used by many researchers across the globe in solving various societal concerns. In June 2020, I was ranked among the top 10 credible scientists of the 500 authors of the scholarly research output of the University of Ilorin, published by Stiva, and latest second best scientist that made industrial chemistry my department to be at the top of Uni Ilorin research output between 2015 and now. These numerous recognitions from different local, national, and international sources are due to undiluted, rigorous training and guidance received from my main mentor, the highly resourceful Professor Folan Amao Adekola, FRSC, FCSN, FIFAM, FMSN, the immediate past dean, Faculty of Physical Sciences, University of Ilorin. Thank you very much, sir. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, please permit me to ask Professor Adekola to please stand up for recognition. Professor Adekola, with your respect, please stand up, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, for about 2 decades now, my research efforts have concentrated on developing feasible, low-cost, low-energy, and environmentally friendly techniques that have been adding value to many Nigerian source minerals and material resources by aqueous metallurgical method for defined industrial applications. The applicability of my established and developed processes has also been extended to the treatment of secondary material resources for improved industrial utilization. These are geared towards providing an alternative source of income for the country's economic growth and development, and as a possible alternative to the declining national foreign earnings from petroleum exploration, among others. Thus, my exciting and successful breakthrough over the years in hydrometallurgical research, focusing on leaching, solvent extraction, precipitation, absorption, and beneficiation of minerals and material resources, has yielded the following results. zinc ores. With increasing demand of zinc and purified zinc compound in Nigeria, an urgent search for indigenous industrial zinc metal and its purity for use in galvanizing and basic chemicals, basic industry, for example, Baba and Adekola in 2010 successfully processed by leaching with hydrochloric acid solution the Akiri, the Abakaliki, and Yimba origin sphalerite ore, containing the following mineral elements as displayed. As the kinetics of dissolution of sulfide minerals in chloride media has received considerable attention recently due to its availability of materials for construction with improved resistance to chloride attack, the enrichment of Abakaliki sphalerite ore has been successfully experimented by Baba and Adekola 2010 in hydrochloric acid media and found to be consistent with the following stoichiometry as summarized by equation 4. One of the economic breakthroughs of this research is the conversion of obnoxious H2S released as a byproduct from equation 4 to elemental sulfur. Sulfur is an important non-metallic product that has wide application in pharmaceutical and other allied industries. To this end, the hydrogen sulfide gas in equation 4 was successfully converted to elemental sulfur through the equation 6 as displayed. The residual bright yellow product containing sulfur was air dried and later often dried at a temperature of 60 degrees centigrade for 12 hours. It has a melting point of 113.8 degrees centigrade with a yield of 99.1% purity, and the product is ready for use in defined pharmaceutical application, Baba and Adekola 2010, Baba et al. 2012A. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, during leaching, the pregnant solution often contains different concentration of metal ion. Baba and Adekola 2011A further treated the Abakaliki sphalerite leach liquor using combination of solvent extraction, precipitation, and cementation technique in the purification and recovery of 95.48% zinc from loaded organic phase by this 2,4-trimethylpentylphosphinic acid, otherwise referred to as cyanide-272 in kerosene extractants. With cyanide-272 extractant at optimal condition, the stream solution, that is the recovered one, containing pure zinc was successfully presented as zinc oxide. The zinc oxide, with about 10.3% purity, with melting point of 1,950 degrees centigrade, will be used as an important coating material for pigment, mild skin irritation, abrasion, and galvanization. Baba et al. 2012A. I have showcased this important product at the 2012 exhibition of the Nigerian University Research and Development Fair held at Federal University of Technology Union, Nigeria, between 8 to 12 October 2012 for industrial utilization and awareness. This is a first index study on hydrological recovery of zinc from the Nigerian sphalerite ore using cyanide 272 extractant and extract from my PhD of 2008 that contained 675 pages that was ranked fourth among other dissertations at the Department of Chemistry and awarded the best in the area of physical sciences University of London in 2009 and subsequently submitted for NUC consideration. Apart from the sphalerite treatment by chemical method, we have also explored the biohydrometallurgical approach in the enrichment of sphalerite or using this sort of hydrophilic bacteria, the use of microorganisms such as tuberculosis ferocidas in metal solubilization process has attracted much attention in recent years. The leaching of metal using microorganisms is very attractive because of its low and relatively few pollution problems and compared with conventional hydrometallurgical processes. In this context, Baba and Adekola, in conjunction with some vibrant microbiologists from the University of Illinois and CSIR, IMT, Bhubaneswar, India, have successfully developed as a substitute to conventional but very scarce Theobacillus ferociferans bacteria, the mixed culture of acidophilic bacteria obtained from the rust trap and motor dump site in the pathology in the Illinois West Local Government area of Kwara State, culture in 9K medium. The photomicrographs of the isolated mixed culture as observed on a petri plate and underfield emission scanning electron microscope gave the following morphological characterization as summarized in Table 2. Lead ores. Galena, the chief ore of lead and one of the most widely distributed metallic sulfide, occurs in both igneous and sedimentary rocks. It is commonly associated with other sulfide minerals such as sphalerite, pyrite, chalcopyrite, and arsenopyrite. Baba et al. 2012A. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, due to the increased demand For lead in automobile battery, basic chemicals and other allied industries in Nigeria and other developing countries of the world, the need to continuously develop simple and practicable routes for the recovery of the valuable metal from Nigerian galena becomes paramount. It is important to note that some of the pure lead end users in Nigeria include Sunshine Battery, located at Ikotepene in Akwa Ibom State, Iveto Group in Ewe Anambra State, and West African Battery in Ibadan Oyo State are no longer in operation presently due to lack of genuine raw material resources, poor funding, and general maintenance challenges, among others. For sustaining some and the life of the aforementioned industry to have reliable raw materials to be in continuous operation, the galena also from Abakaliki and Yingba origin has been quantitatively studied in hydrochloric acid solution, Baba and Adekola 2012. The insufficient kinetic studies to explain the complete dissolution of galena in hydrochloric acid media in literature warrant our trial among others. Most of the available dissolution studies did not address some basic important kinetic parameters such as reaction order, activation energy, Arrhenius factor, reaction constant, and this often makes the proposition of dissolution kinetic difficult. It was also observed that at high HCl concentration, lead ion exists mainly as stable chloride complex, and when the solution is far from equilibrium without reverse reaction and secondary materials, the rate of equation for HCl concentration could be expressed as summarized in equation 8. From equation 8, the rate of dissolution of the study Abakaliki galena ore was found to be 1.37 times 10 to the power minus 4 mole per second, mole per liter per second, Baba and Adekola 2012. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, for more than 2 decades, for example, and in view of the intrinsic nature of chloride-rich liquor that are radar complex, Baba and Adekola 2013 have successfully used surface extraction technique for the purification, separation, and concentration of metals from aqueous chloride media by initially considering the following organophosphorus extractants as summarized in Table 3. Till date, hydrometallurgical treatment have received significant attention for the treatment of the lead mineral because of the difficulties encountered with conventional pyrometallurgical methods. As leaching is an important unit operation in the hydrometallurgical processes, the selection of an appropriate leaching reagent is beneficial to this process. Consequently, we have developed a new approach to solve the aforementioned concern using sulfuric acid, Baba Eta 2019A. Thus, the potential of GOCO venous source galena ore with the following assay was quantitatively investigated by Baba Eta 2019B. The estimated activation energy of about 28.4 kilojoules per mole with reaction order of 0.758 supported the proposed diffusion control mechanism for the dissolution process that is consistent with equation 10. Clay minerals. Clay minerals such as talc and kaolin are among the most important industrial minerals with diverse industrial applications depending on the physical and morphological property of the mineral. Layered silicate minerals such as talc ore are prime interest due to their extensive uses in industry. Talc main industrial applications are in paper, paint, cosmetic, plastic, refractory materials, pesticides, agro industry, and ceramic, depending on its physical properties, chemistry, and mineralogy. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, we have, however, developed acid leaching technique in the selective dissolution of gas minerals from the central source Kogi State talc ore to obtain purified talc products suitable for defined industrial uses. At a set of experimental conditions, the ore dissolution reached 62.1% as established. The essence of iron removal, as evident by EDS, showed a decrease in iron content from 3.75 to 0.36% and account for about 90.4% process efficiency. Baba Eta 2015B. This work is one of the most outstanding researches in applied clay mineral science and applications till date. Kaolin ores. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, you will recall that the report of the recent 2020 National Technical Working Group on Minerals and Metals Development in 2016 showed that Nigerian kaolin annual national demand is 250,000 tons, while the present annual production is just 5,000 tons. To bridge the gap, Baba Eta 2017B successfully developed a feasible approach to prepare a high-grade alumina of industrial value. This research breakthrough at the Agrometallurgy and Mineral Processing Unit, Department of Industrial Chemistry of this great university, has combined acid leaching, calcination, and precipitation technique to achieving 93.7% process efficiency. The produced alumina, as characterized, is expected to find application as fillers in plastic and ceramic industry, coagulants in water treatment, and for metallurgical uses in aluminum plants. I am happy to inform the audience that this product was showcased at the exhibition of the Science, Technology and Innovation Expo 2017, held at the Eagle Square, Abuja, and was one of the research products that placed the University of Ilorin in the third position overall. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, the increasing demands for pure aluminum and aluminum oxide of industrial grade for use in pigment, catalysis, water purification, aluminum production, and metallurgical application prompted us to develop a feasible, low-cost, and eco-friendly technique for processing a Nigerian bauxite-rich ore sourced from Nanegida Bangudu area of Zamfara State to industrial aluminum by hydrometallurgical process, Baba Eta 2019 B and C. Here, three basic units of operation, leaching solvent and solvent extraction and precipitation method were employed. Thus, at optimal condition, the chemical analysis for the prepared alumina is comparable to the industrial standard as established, as well as the efficiency of the process yielded 98.3%, and the product as characterized will find application in catalytic and water purification. It is important to note that the excellent results obtained from the treatment of Nanegida Bangudu kaolinite ore, which was reported by Baba Eta 2019 B and C, Raji and Baba Eta 2020, excited some international partners and industrialists to approach my laboratory through one of my PhD students, Mr. Raji Mustafa Adekunle, for possible upgrading of pyrographic sample to industrial alumina by hydrometallurgical process. The upgrade project, which has since commenced under my supervision, is required by POSCO Company, South Africa. It is believed that the two parties will derive immeasurable benefits from the research output. One of the conventional methods for alum production for water treatment is through bauxite ore production, purification. As this ore is rarely available, in large quantities in Nigeria, one of the feasible approaches is to produce aluminum from a typical kaolin ore. Thus, for economical consideration and energy-saving purpose, kaolin with greater than 35% per weight is often used as an alternative for alum production in this regard. In view of these challenges, we have developed the extraction and recovery route for aluminum from Batagbon in the local government area of Kwara State by sulfuric acid in the presence of prosilic acid. The recovery of aluminum at optimal condition yielded 84.3% efficiency. The produced alum was found to compete favorably with high-grade imported alum for domestic and defined industrial uses. Adekola and Baba Eta 2016. Copper ores. Till date, approximately 700 million metric tons of copper ore deposits have been estimated around the world. And the defined mineable deposit contains an estimated of 2.1 billion metric tons of additional copper, which brings the total amount of discovered copper to about 2.8 billion metric tons, with undiscovered resources estimated at 3.5 billion metric tons of copper on Earth. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, due to various interests that include environmental aspects and the possibility of increased exploitation of mid and lower grade ores, a relatively small isolated deposit inspired me to instruct one of my postgraduate students to focus on copper processing, as there has been a worldwide upsurge of interest in hydrometallurgical processing of chalcopyrite ore for the production of high-grade copper and in late 2012. In this regard, we have successfully provided useful information on kinetic parameters for copper extraction for the chalcopyrite ore source from Akiri Village, our local government area of Nasarawa State, as detailed by Baba Eta 2013-D. The extraction and purification of copper by Dataso in kerosene from aqueous chloride Akiri Chalcopyrite leach liquor, whose composition as summarized was investigated by Baba Eta 2015-C. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, I am happy to inform the audience that the beneficiated copper 2 oxide, as characterized could find application as three types of semiconductors. The results from this investigation, which I presented through the full sponsorship by the University of Ilorin at the 2015 Mineral Processing Technology of the India Institute of Metals, held at Andhra Pradesh, held at Andhra University, Visakhapatnam, India, was ranked the best and won the first position prize in the hydro and bio hydrometallurgical research category. Since the state has earned the hydrometallurgy and mineral processing laboratory at the University of Ilorin international recognition. Copperlite, being a secondary copper sulfide, mineral containing 66% of copper, has drawn significant interest as a superconductor and natural CUS show excellent metal conductivity and condense into superconducting state below 1.6 Kelvin. For this reason, sir, the use of ammonium sulfate solution for the treatment of Wugari, Taraba State source covalent ore has been documented by Baba Eta 2017 D with 86.2% of copper reacted within 120 minutes. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, it is important to note that treatment of copper ore in sulfate media resulted in the formation of elemental sulfur, which often impede the process kinetics by forming participating layer on the ore reactor particle. Another drawback is the contamination of the leaching liquor, which with iron due to simultaneous dissolution and stability of copper and iron, thus chalcopyrite leaching in aqueous ammonia leads to the formation of sulfate instead of elemental sulfur due to high pH of ammoniac media. In view of the foregoing, sir, the characterization and kinetic study on ammonia leaching of complex copper ore from Kokonen District, Nasarawa State, was successively investigated at the Department of Hydro and Electrometallurgy, CSIR, Institute of Minerals and Material Technology, Bhubaneswar, India, under the guidance of my postdoctoral research supervisor, Dr. Malekuma Ghosh. The results have found that ammoniac leaching using oxygen gas under pressure is a feasible treatment route for coconut ore to have selective dissolution of copper. Under the standard leaching condition, it is possible to achieve 83% of copper recovery in 2.5 hours. However, under high ammonia concentration and lower particle size, greater than 95% of copper extraction is feasible. The distinctive result obtained from this investigation was ranked as the best in the institute and was the one of the highly rated researches that earned me Diamond Award as the most valued postdoctoral fellow of the institute on the 17th of January 2012. Manganese ore. Manganese is an essential ingredient in steel and alloys, dietary additives, fertilizers, and fine chemicals, among others. Pyrrhotite, one of the major ores of manganese, is widely distributed in the earth crust and used extensively for the manufacturing of various ferromanganese alloys. However, the unfavorable economic and environmental pressures for manganese production through blast furnace drove our interest to find alternative methods that consume low energy, less capital, and with high metal selectivity without causing air pollution. Consequently, we investigated and provided detailed characterization and dissociative kinetic analysis of the KB state pyrrhotite ore in HUSO4 media. Baba Eta 2015 D. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, the recovery of total manganese from sulfuric acid leach KB pyrrhotite ore was previously examined through the combination of sulfate extraction and precipitation technique prior to beneficiation of the pyrrhotite solution as manganese oxide, Baba Eta 2016 A. Iron, which forms the major impurity in the pregnant solution, was successfully removed through pyrrhotite method at pH of 3.5 and process recorded 99.75% success. The beneficiation of the recovered pure manganese solution to obtain high-grade manganese oxide was proposed for use in steel production. I presented the result of this investigation, including the hydrometallurgical scheme for the operational extraction procedure amenable for industrial utilization and economic sustainability at the third joint UCC Unilorin International Conference held at University of Cape Coast, Accra, Ghana in August 2013. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, with the extensive exploitation and consumption of high-grade manganese ore, considerable attention must continuously be focused on the development and utilization of low-grade manganese ore. Pyrrhotite, for example, and most importantly, fessantine ore, are examples of industrial manganese material that can be processed
in meeting the demand of steel and allied industry, Baba Eta 2018-8. These, among others, have guided the focus of my research group on developing low-cost and eco-friendly routes for purifying the manganese ore to meet some defined industrial demand. One of them is our research on reductive leaching. Reductive leaching and sulfate extraction technique for the precursor of Caldean Northwest presenting ore that gave 80.2% ore reaction within 120 minutes. Baba Eta 2018-8. Recently, the use of phosphoric acid as a reductant, owing to its availability, high acidic strength, and the ability to form metal ion selectivity for further enrichment of Caldean presenting ore was successfully reported by Baba Eta 2020-D. The result at optimal leaching conditions yielded 97.2% efficiency within 120 minutes compared to 80.2% when strength T was used as a reducing agent. Ilmenite and rutile ores. The processing of ilmenite for the production of pigment grade titanium oxide often becomes difficult due to its high iron content. This is because of the limitation of the availability of natural rutile resources. In order to meet the demand for high-grade titanium ore, commercial practice, including roasting and smelting, are followed to upgrade the ilmenite resources by removing iron oxide and other impurities. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir. The aforementioned methods for upgrading ilmenite to synthetic rutile are energy-intensive, sir, coupled with the expensive process design. As alternative to minimize intensive energy disposals, we have successfully used acidic leaching, cool mechanical activation, followed by alkali roasting to treat SAGBE, developing local government area of Kwara State ilmenite ore resources for industrial value additions. Baba Eta 2013-C. The SAGBE ilmenite, as characterized, was one of my breakthroughs, and it formed part of my distinct findings at the CSIRMT Bhubaneswar, India, during my postdoctoral research fellowship between 2011 and 2012. During this investigation, we reported the mechanical activation significantly enhances the dissolution of the ilmenite ore under the established condition. 72% of titanium extraction was achieved from a milled ore roasted at 850 degrees centigrade by 60% sodium hydroxide with fallible compound detected, as summarized in figures 5A and B. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, it is important to note that low palladium concentration from opionigmi ilmenite ore examined by SCPMS technique made the ore to be suitably fit for industrial application in sulfate process plants. An extraction efficiency of 96% total titanium was obtained by 1.5 molar TDP in kerosene from initial 10 grams per liter leach liquor at 27 degrees centigrade in the single extraction stage. Iron ores. The possibility of producing ferric chloride crystal from the iron ore concentrate obtained from National Iron Ore and Mining Project, Itape, Kogi State, for water filtration was reported over a decade ago by Baba Eta 2005-8. The iron concentrate, with 66.7% weight per iron contains, among others, 0.06% phosphorus, which also makes it suitable for steel production. Steel, of which iron is the key ingredient, is the world's most commonly used metal, representing almost 95% of all metal used per year. It is useful in structural engineering and for mining purposes, automobile and general industrial applications. Baba Eta 2017-E. Cassiterite ore. The fast development of science and technology, coupled with some properties of tin, such as malleability, ductility, and resistance to corrosion, make pure tin metal useful for a wide array of utilization in tin plating, foam pad, alloy, and metal coating, among others. In addition to this, the composition of pure tin metal and its compound are increasing tremendously as a result of this, as a result of the versatile end uses, with the global price equivalent of about $22,000 per metric ton. It is many times more valuable than refined zinc. Baba Eta 2020-A. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir. In view of the above justification, we have recently reported the potential of cassiterite ore in Lati Aji, a local government area of Kwara State, for industrial steel coating application. The result of our investigation, which has attracted remarkable applause, was presented at the Minerals, Metal and Material Society of the Pan American Material Congress, TMS 2020, the World Comes Here, held in San Diego, California, USA, in February 2020. just before the advent of the COVID-19 pandemic. I was there. It was affirmed that the Lafayette Jesus Catholic Hall was successfully transformed to tin chloride of industrial utility with extraction efficiency of 89.3%. This novel study shows the possibility of producing high-grade domestic and industrially acceptable tin chloride, suitable as steel coating material in some defined industry by hydrometallurgical process. This study is therefore expected to contribute to the country's economy through industrialization and poverty reduction, especially when the Ajaokuta steel industry resumes full operation. Wolframites. Sir, permit me at this moment to say that Baba Eta 2018B has carried out wolframite processing derived from Lafayette mineral deposit. As a result of that, pure tungsten was successfully recovered as FET and beneficial to produce high-grade tungsten oxide of industrial value. Sir, permit me at this moment to pay a glowing tribute to one of the contributing authors, a hard-working agricultural physicist, Mr. Mohammed O. Mohammed, a reliable and early MSc graduate, who passed away on Wednesday, 26 February 2020. May Allah forgive his shortcoming and grant him Al-Jannah Firdaus. As part of our effort in this field, we have recently reported the possibility of obtaining ammonium metatungstate AMT from Anka Samphara salt wolframite ore by hydrometallurgical process. The AMT produced is another form of tungsten compound widely used in the preparation of industrial tungsten alloys and ammonium phosphotungstate for catalytic application by Gridisu and Baba 2021, Baba Eta 2021B, beryl ores. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, the preparation and optimization of the beryl leach liquors were also carried out to obtain high-grade beryl oxide, beryl sulfate, beryl chloride, as well as aluminum oxide for specific industrial utility at the hydrometallurgy and mineral processing plant, Department of Industrial Chemistry, University of Ilorin. Each of these products is available for exhibition in our laboratory. For example, preparation of high-grade beryllium oxide for industrial application by hydrometallurgical process was presented at the 4th Association of West African University Conference, held at Université Félix Houphouët Boigny, Abidjan, in Côte d'Ivoire in October 2016, Baba and Ola Oluwa 2016, calcite and barite ores. In Nigeria, there is a fine deposit of calcite ore in the Benue Trough, Sokoto and Chad Basin. However, the ore near Calabar, with estimated reserve of 30 billion metric tons, is the purest deposit in Nigeria. Till date, calcite ore is widely used as cross-stone buildings for building purpose, roadbeds and railway lines, production of asbestos, and so on. It will be a worldwide venture to upgrade calcite ore uses for producing high-grade hydroxyl apatite for defined industrial application. HAP is an important inorganic biomaterial with a wide area of uses in bio, medical, and dental applications due to its similarity to main mineral component of hard tissue of human bone. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, we have successfully carried out a study on the enrichment of Ewekoro, Ogun State, calcite ore deposit by hydrothermal method, Baba Eta 2016B. At optimal condition, a rectangular rod-like layer HAP powder formed yielded calcium phosphorus ratio of about 1.66, which is close to the stoichiometric ratio of 1.67 required for biomedical application. In the same phase, our effort at producing high-grade barium sulfate compound from Asara Nasarawa State barite ore deposit for use as drilling mud for oil and gas application has started yielding positive results. For example, we have developed various leaching routes to remove appropriate impurities from barite ore bodies to obtain greater than 90% pure barium sulfate for use as drilling agent for defined oil and gas industries. The properties of the well-characterized barium sulfate obtained at optimal condition were in accordance with the API standard, as reported by Olasiri and Baba 2020. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, due to time and space constraint, please permit me to summarize some of our other works in mineral processing from different sources in Nigeria and across the globe, aimed at engendering economic sustainability and development, as shown in Table 3. Material resources. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, please recall that earlier in the course of today's inaugural lecture, I informed the August audience that there is concurrent increase in demand for many metals such as zinc, lead, gold, tin and so on for defined industrial applications, which has led to gradual depletion of these non-renewable resources. This gradual depletion calls for measures aimed at recovering of these resources from spent material for sustained industrial utilization. This, among others, has led to our research direction toward the recovery of the industrial metal values and useful compounds from the secondary material resources using the optimization of developed mineral processing routes, which are not limited to zinc carbon batteries. In most of Sub-Saharan Africa, zinc batteries constitute by far the most dominant portion and could therefore be considered as one of the valuable secondary raw materials for the recovery of zinc and other precious metals for defined industrial uses. The world annual production of small portable batteries characterized with distinct shape and sizes is more than 100 billion. Out of this mass production, zinc carbon battery cover approximately 31%. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, the potential of solvent extraction using Sinex 272 for the recovery of zinc from spent zinc carbon battery after a trial leaching in hydrochloric acid was successfully investigated by Baba et al. 2009-8. The spent zinc carbon batteries, the cheapest and the most popular brand, Tiger Head brand in China, made in China, in Nigerian market were collected, processed, examined by SCPMS, and they were found to contain the following compound as summarized on the screen. The SRD analysis also showed that the post-leaching residue contained mainly alpha quartz. As the post-leaching residue is non-hazardous, it can therefore be sent to the factory for reuse. Recently, my group successfully extracted zinc from zinc carbon battery from leached liquor and subsequently beneficiated the solution to obtain 98.5% pure zinc. Zinc oxide, suitable as coating and industrial raw material for some indigenous industries. The hydrometallurgical flow chart for the economic metal rescue from zinc carbon battery for defined industrial application was provided. This work was among the highly rated research in the energy technology and carbon dioxide management symposium at the recently held TMS 2020 annual meeting and exhibition in San Diego, California, USA. Automobile batteries. The high level of poverty in some developing countries, especially in sub-Saharan Africa, has steadily increased motorcycle utilization due to its commercial value, which, if not put under control, could become nuisance to the society, Baba et al. 2010. In this context, Baba et al. 2013 has successfully used liquid-liquid extraction to affirm that Dietazone is a good candidate for extracting lead two from motorcycle battery as leachate. At optimal conditions, 98.4% of the total lead was extracted into organic phase by 0.1 molar Dietazone chloroform and was recovered 95.1% of total lead was actually achieved. Printed circuit board. The productions of electrical and electronic devices are the fastest growing sector in the manufacturing industry. Every year, 20 to 50 million tons of electrical and electronic equipment are produced worldwide, which could pose great risks to human health and the environment when not properly managed. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, we have also successfully developed the energy-saving approach of metal extraction from e-waste printed circuit board by Sinex 272 in chloride medium. This was reported at the second consortium 2014 International Conference, CPET, Cape Town in South Africa, Baba et al., Baba and Ahmed 2014. The e-waste used in this study were discarded Dell desktop PCB. They were obtained from a waste collection point situated at Morris Junction, Minna, Niger State of Nigeria. This is the main area in Minna where used electronic gadgets are dumped. Spent deposited sludge transformer oil. For many decades, the transformer oil has been a major threat to the environment due to high content in polychlorinated biphenol. Globally, 30 to 40 billion liters of mineral oils are presently utilized in transformers and the demand will tremendously increase with time. The transformer oils often serve as an insulation and coolant within the transformer. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, due to fluctuating crude oil prices and the COVID-19 pandemic that apparently locked down the global economy and the desire to diversify Nigeria's economy, recycling initiative is another preferred option to address this economic meltdown. To this end, Baba et al. 2019-C has successfully employed leaching and sulfur extraction technique to treat spent DSTO obtained from Ayetoro 3, 300 kVA distribution, transformer having 245 kg oil weight capacity with about 25 kg of recoverable combined sludge oil mixture. As the oil application is required for keeping the transformer power voltage operating at the optimal capacity. Successful regeneration of pure oxidized transformer oils has led to ascertain its potency with respect to the metrical standard testing and measurement regulation indicating its suitability and refining to meet some defined industrial need. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, with everyday records of several million tons of eggshells as bio waste across the world, and in line with the Waste to Wealth initiative of the Federal Government of Nigeria, Baba Eta 2026 has recently examined the process of HAP powder, successfully prepared using tanker source, calcium, waste, post-eggshell, fear chemical preparation method with phosphoric acid as a precursor. At a set of experimental conditions, the pure crystal of HAP powder with about a calcium phosphorus ratio of 1.66 as against 1.67 was well characterized for its possible use in biomedical application. This high-grade product is relatively cheaper as compared to the industrially available HAP powder produced through energy-intensive thermal process, which is sold between 638 and 795 per kilogram. This HAP powder produced in our laboratory has attracted enormous commendation with keen interest developed by the Minister of Science and Technology, Dr. Christopher Ogbonnoyanwolu, and the University Director of Laboratory to Product Center, Professor Adedeji, showcased my HAP product to the Honorable Minister at the exhibition of the Science and Technology Innovation Expo 2020 that was held between 15th to 20th of March in Abuja. Mr. Olohun, please, can you please play the recorded Radio Nigeria?
Farah Baba has introduced a new medical procedure for reconstruction of bone tissues. Professor Baba, who is the head Department of Industrial Chemistry, University of Ilorin, made this known at the ongoing 2020 Science, Technology and Innovation Expo in Abuja, corresponding Victoria Abba has details.
Speaking at the ongoing expo in Abuja, Professor Alafara Baba, while highlighting some of the benefits of the medical procedure, said it would help in converting waste to wealth.
For this expo 2020, we are able to make use of they are very useful for orthopedic and biomedical applications. This is also a research that can actually contribute to quantity of the good and
also, Dr. Alabi Babatunde,
Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, due to the want of time and space, please permit me to summarize some of my other research achievements on material resources carried out successfully in Nigeria and other parts of the globe. Table 4. In conclusion, Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, this lecture has clearly demonstrated that Nigeria is abundantly and richly blessed with immeasurable mineral and material resources, with high potential to solve the country's needs if adequately and effectively harnessed. This gesture will contribute to the country's economic and technological growth and development, and thereby invigorate the desire of the country to diversify its economy from the current sole dependence on petroleum as a source of foreign exchange. In view of my discerned endeavors and contributions spanning about 2 decades ago, this lecture concludes that 1. The findings of the reported studies underline the importance of the adoption of hydrometallurgic techniques in the minerals and material processing for socio-economic development and sustainability in Nigeria by ensuring significant full-scale utilization of the abundant untapped mineral and material resources. 2, the hydrometallurgical method can be successfully exploited to replace other mineral and material processing methods that are generally expensive with high energy consumption and environmentally hazardous. 3, the beneficiation of spent materials to high-grade industrial products in compliance with the Waste to Wealth initiative of the Federal Government of Nigeria as another viable source of revenue generation can be strengthened through hydrometallurgical process. And 4, further development and genuine collaborative research can be successfully undertaken at the agrometallurgy and mineral processing plant our mineral processing research unit, Department of Industrial Chemistry, University of Ilorin, to redefine and promote technological advancement for sustainable economic growth. My recommendation, sir. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, following the highlights of my research activities described in this lecture, you will agree with me that the hydrometallurgical processing as a means of optimizing the quality of Nigeria mineral and secondary materials for industrial value addition has not been given the desired attention. However, it is evident that Nigerian source mineral resources have high economic value, but unfortunately have not been effectively harnessed. This is because of the apathy and preference of many local industries for imported raw materials. However, when local and secondary raw materials are fully tapped, it will stem the importation of refined products, thereby preserving our hard-earned foreign exchange, improving the economy, reducing unemployment and poverty, and sustaining the industrial growth and development. Therefore, I recommend as follows, sir. One, the use of locally sourced refined mineral and material resources for the country's industry that will enable the country to save a significant proportion of our hard and foreign exchange pool should be rigorously pursued. This becomes pertinent with the downturn in the world's economy following the COVID-19 pandemic. By these measures, income earned from this can be used to complement those derived from the petroleum exploration, which could be used to cushion the effect of the economic meltdown occasioned by the COVID-19 pandemic. Two, government and other relevant stakeholders should, as a matter of urgency, put necessary machinery in motion to revive the many indigenous steel plants and allied industry to boost the country's economy and create employment for the country's teeming unemployed youth. Three, the Ministry of Mines and Solid Mineral Development and other critical stakeholders should form alliance with hydrometallurgy and mineral processing plant units of our department and similar laboratories across the country to promote and fund researches in science and technology, especially on the beneficiation, that is adding value to all these Nigerian mineral resources for industrial value addition. This will propel economic prosperity by reducing direct export of these minerals, which are often sold at lower prices to the detriment of our economic well-being, sir. Fourth, the establishment of a hydrometallurgy and mineral processing research center in the university, equipped with the state-of-art facilities, is urgently required to improve the quality of research that will effectively contribute to nation building and development. This can be facilitated in conjunction with the Federal Ministry of Solid Mineral Development and Mine and Steel Development. The two ministries are here today, sir. Five, the development of a roadmap that will promote a linkage between research and industry should be put in place for the optimized translational and transformational value chain transmission. Six, the government should put in more effort in the implementation of its waste-to-wealth initiative to facilitate industrial growth, reduce poverty, and promote environmental sustainability. Seven, as no nation can develop without research and genuine innovations, government should, as a matter of national emergency, address the poor infrastructures in various tertiary institutions, provide substantial funds for cutting-edge researches, support indigenous researchers, and adequately promote the utilization of local raw materials and manufactured goods. This, if fully implemented, sir, will launch the country into a community of industrial nations where Nigeria truly deserves to be. On this note, I wish to go on acknowledging the following, sir. Acknowledgement, sir. No word can be enough to sufficiently capture my limitless thanks, profound appreciation and adoration to the Almighty Allah, the Lord of the worlds, the all-kind and ever-merciful, who have absolute knowledge, but inspire whom he pleases with a bit of it. May the peace and blessings of Allah continue to be on the soul of the noblest of mankind, Muhammad Rasulullah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his household and companions. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen for the privilege he granted me to contribute my own quota towards solving societal problems. The presentation of today's inaugural lecture is another glowing testimony of his magnanimity towards me, making it possible to showcase the essence of my scientific research endeavors in seeking practicable solutions to women's societal and national challenges thus far. Definitely, in doing this, the Almighty Allah has used a lot of people, some of whom are physically present to witness today's lecture. To all of you, I say big thank you on behalf of myself and entire Alafara family. However, I have to specifically acknowledge some people that Allah has used to hone my journey so far. First of all, I sincerely thank the dynamic and hardworking Vice Chancellor, University of Ilorin, Professor Sulaiman Age Abdulkarim, for giving me the opportunity to deliver the inaugural lecture. I owe him yet another gratitude that during his leadership, I attained the professorial chair with effect from 1st October 2017 and for appointing me the head of Industrial Chemistry Department. Thank you very much, sir. However, I have done nothing to ordinarily deserve what Allah has blessed me with. I will be nothing if not for Allah's mercy and the beneficence and honor of my parents, Alhaji Baba Buhari Alafara, and my late mother, Alhaji Sifao Anike Baba Alafara, who, as obedient servant of Allah, gave birth to me, nurtured me, and gave me all support to succeed. I pray Allah take good care of them, as indeed they took care of me when I was young. To my guardians, the late Alhaji Anabi Lowori Arafara, whose very corrective and Hispanic guidance kept me on track at the most fundamental campus beginning, and Alhaji Busarelade is here, retired principal officer, principal assistant registrar, University of Ilorin, and former commissioner of finance, Kwara State, is also here. May Allah reward them abundantly and be pleased with the debt. I equally pray to Allah to repose the soul of my late grandparents, Malam and Mrs. Amin Baba Alapara, and grant them at Jannah Firdaus. I value the support of my siblings, Baba Abusa Sali Ibrahim Ramat Alapara. May Allah continue to be our guide and bless the soul of Fatima and Abdul Wahid Alapara, and grant them at Jannah Firdaus. The untiring effort of Amin Abatili, Salamat Belau, and Antinagode, Ajara Tagunko, Kusumu Olowo, Suebat Abayao, and Mrs. Adijat Ahmed Baba Edualafara, on my professional development is well acknowledged. The unique, ever memorable, most appreciable guidance of my PhD MSc supervisor and immediate past dean, Faculty of Physical Sciences, Professor F.A. Adekola, is highly appreciated, sir. His uncommon erudition, real humility, and exemplary zeal to lift others up are my assurance that he is destined for greatness. May the Almighty Allah bless him and his progeny. I am also highly indebted to my teachers, Professors M.A. Mesubi, my MSc post-professor, Professor Ayo Abimbola, my undergraduate supervisor, Professor Olondari, who taught me ingredients of teaching as a profession and quality of a good teacher, and Dr. Melekuma Ghosh, my postdoctoral fellowship supervisor in Orissa State, India. I sincerely appreciate the Library and Publication Committee of the University, particularly the immediate past chairman, Professor S.F. Ambali, for adding value to this lecture, the current chairman, Professor A.K. Salami, for his support, and to Dr. Ilias Rasak Ayodeji, Federal University, Dusima, and Professor Mahfuz Adedimeji, Pioneer Vice Chancellor, Ahmad Patidji University, for the editorial assistance. I am thankful to my teachers and senior colleagues at the Department of Chemistry, University of Ilorin. I also thank my teachers at College of Education, Ilorin. In fact, Mr. Segoyomi taught me mathematics. Mrs. Balogun is also here. Montcalm College, I have Mr. Barika that taught me English while I was in secondary school, even primary school, is also here. At Alore Local School Management, Management Board, Alhaji Issa Ibrahim, my primary CSA teacher, is also here. I thank all of you, Professor D.S. Oguni and Professor Adenike Tioladiji. I thank you all for guidance, training, and mentorship provided, especially during the time I served under you as Deputy Director, Central Research Laboratory of this university. I also own Professor Suhaib Baba Ibrahim, the former Vice Chancellor of the University of Ilorin, a profound gratitude. He graciously facilitated my appointment into the University of Ilorin on the 4th of June 2002. Jazakumullah Harisa. In the same faith, I acknowledge Professor Ayo Oloyede for appointing me to serve in the University Town and Grant Committee, being my first ever University Committee assignment in 2009, and Professor Abiganiu Ambali, OON, for kickstarting the process of my promotion to the rank of professor, and for finding me worthy of appointment as the Deputy Director, Central Research Laboratory of this Citadel of Learning between 2014 and 2017. He also nominated me to represent the university at the International Workshop on Research and Development and Innovation at the University of Dayton, Ohio, USA, in August 2015. This unique opportunity has very positive significance in my research and innovation integrity to date. I appreciate the interest and tremendous support constantly demonstrated by Professor A.G.F. Alabi and Professor Mrs. Salman. I sincerely acknowledge Professors F.O. Ibrahim, Professor A.Y. Abdulkarim, A.S. Abdulsalam, S.A. Kuranga, B.F. Sule, B.O. Yusuf, Y.A. Kodri, Omoteso, Professor M.M. Akambi, S.A.N., Vice Chancellor Kwasu, A.B. Olaemi, and I.O. Arosaye. My profound gratitude to other professors, senior colleagues, and colleagues whose names are boldly written as displayed on the screen are respectively acknowledged. Thank you very much, SARS and MAS. To my senior and junior colleagues in the Department of Industrial Chemistry and Chemistry of this university, I acknowledge your contribution to my research endeavors. The effort of all laboratory and technical staff are gratefully acknowledged. The various assistants of administrative staff of the department and the Faculty of Physical Sciences are applauded. I appreciate your immeasurable contribution that have sustained my headship of the Department of Industrial Chemistry of this university. To my distinct agrometallurgy and material co-researchers in and outside Nigeria, as well displayed on the screen, you are well acknowledged. I thank you all for accepting to collaborate and share ideas with me. The working relationship of the material family in Nigeria under the amiable National President, Professor Mrs. Okoria, where are you? Professor Okoria, National President of MSN, you are welcome. And the Nigerian chemists, under the leadership of the immediate past and current National President, Professor Okeniyi and M. Chindo, the Mineral Metals and Material Society, TMS of Pan American Material Congress, USA, under the Executive Director of Professor John Robinson, EPD Chair, Professor Cindy Bett, and Chair Hydro and Electrometallurgy Committee, Associate Professor Gizele Azimi, where I'm currently serving as a board member and secretary of the Hydrometallurgy. I greatly appreciate your contribution in boosting my research endeavors globally. I sincerely appreciate our ethical silence at the hardworking Executive Governor of Kwara State, His Excellency Mollam Abdulrahman Abrasak, for giving me today's honor by his physical presence that was represented by the Deputy Governor of Kwara State to this inaugural lecture. I pray Allah to continue to protect and guide him in the consensual painstaking process of obtaining Kwara State to greater heights. To our highly respected Royal Father, the custodian of the North Tool of Alimi Dynasty, His Royal Highness, the Emir of Ilorin, and Chairman Kwara State Traditional Council, which is Memantaba Alhaji Dr. Ibrahim Sul Gambari, CFR. If you are represented by Balogun Agba of Ilorin, I am indeed grateful for the honor and prayer organized for me to receive Sheikh Alimi's blessing in your palace following my appointment as a professor in 2017. May Allah continue to strengthen, bless you with long life and sound health and prosperity. By extension, I appreciate the support of Balogun Ajikobi, Balogun Fulani, represented late Alhaji Yusuf Amuda Aliman Alore, alias Bamile Kewu, my Quranic teacher. Sheikh Alhaji Muhibu Lai Ali, my Mukadam of Tijaniya. Sheikh Abdulmumin Ayara, National Missioner and South Islam. Sheikh Abubakar Mubashir Imam, Anadu Nolubwa Mosque, who taught me as Odo Adini in the year 2000, and other ulama in the Ilorin Emirate and Kwara State in general. My special and immeasurable thanks go to the Tertiary Education Trust Fund and so on, the TMS, New York, up to. Above all, I thank the University of Ilorin for various honors and benevolence I enjoy in support of my research endeavors, sir. By extension, I sincerely thank Mr. Late Olufalaja, Engineer Suleiman Alakwansopa, Damu Sami of Ilorin. I thank all of you. In fact, everybody, Alaji, I must not forget to mention Alaji Abubakar Korotapa In fact, I must not forget to mention Maruf Olajimeji, Adesina, Alhaji Ahmed, Rahim, Babatunde Kobiowu, and so on. People are many because of time. Our daughter and daughter, Mrs. Olaguju, Dallas, USA. Dr. Ibrahim Obarewa Clinic, Alhaji Faruk Yusuf, and so on. Very too numerous to mention. I must not forget to mention late barrister Imam Kayode Elesinla and Alhaji Alalaja A.O. Raji, Alhaji Sakri Muhammad Abuja, late Alhaji J.S. Muhammad, our former faculty officer, and Dr. Sally Wahab, my immediate brother, and the acting provost, College of Education, Uro. I am sincerely very grateful to you all. To my students, following from Dr. Kuranga and the rest of you, up to all the awaiting doctors, Olasinde, Ibrahim, Olaoluwa, Grigisu, Adeyemi, Balogun, Raji, Abdulkarim, you are all wonderful. In fact, the success of today's lecture is a collective success engendered by your collaborative efforts, ideas, and input. And thank you very much. I acknowledge the university's wonderful administrative and non-academic staff who have indeed contributed and enriched my working experience till date. The registrar, Professor, by the grace of God, Dr. Ololeni, S.A. Adisa, Mala Afanla Abusalam, Baba Male, Bangoye Sayuti, Late G. Yaya, Baba, Miss Akogun, Aunsi, everybody, you are too many to mention. Up to our bustling wing, I didn't forget to mention our former bossa, Mr. Saka Abiodun, A.A. Ahmed, Abdulbaki, Dere, Akambi Olani, Gobi, Lawal, Ogbede, Duro Wade. To my brothers and sisters, all my youth across Alapara family and extension, I value your constant advice, guidance, and support at all times. To my wonderful friend and colleagues, Dr. Siddiq Masood, Anapi Ahmed, Dr. Sajadi Jima, everybody, too numerous to mention, I value all your contribution. I thank you all for your cordial relationship and friendship. I thank the University of Ilorin, Emire Community, Ilorin, Emire Professors Association, Kwara State Professors Association, University of Ilorin, Ilorin Emirates, the Central Progressive Union, ASU Uni Ilorin. I also appreciate the Moro Group, Badger to Islam, Society of Nigeria, Ilorin Akon Men and Women Initiative, Nakomio, Form 1, Alore, Local School Management Board, Old Kupi Association, especially my first mentors, one is two said that are here, Montana College Old Boys, especially my 1986-87 set. I thank all of you. And where I belong, I know the Central Development Association. My chairman, Mr. Kayode, all of you, I thank you all. And my Alasalatu group, Abib Rahman Society of Nigeria, you are all wonderful. I sincerely appreciate my in-laws, the Akensola family of Ilorin, especially my mother-in-law, Mrs. Baidao, Oba Akensola and her team, Alhaji Salman, Ibrahim Akensola, and Mukada Mobak, Ibrahim Akensola, my brothers and sisters-in-law, who are all here today with their families. Thank you for giving me in marriage a precious, liquid, dependable jewel from your family. I want to express my deepest appreciation to our children for their love, patience, prayers, understanding, and being sources of blessing. Taufikat, Ridwanulai, Aminulai, Aliman, and Muhammad Nasir. Finally, I wholeheartedly appreciate the continuous support and encouragement of my dear friend, my sister, my love, my gogbe, my wife, Alaja Miriam Alake, ni Obakeosola. Thank you very much for taking good care of me, of my own, especially during my consistent absence in pursuance of my filial duty. Sweet that I love you, and then you are indeed a strong pillar of my success. Thank you very much. To all of you who have come to attend this inaugural lecture, and to all who have extended a hand of fellowship to me, I pray that Almighty Allah shower you with his blessing and grant you journey mercies as you return to your various destinations. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, please permit me to end this inaugural lecture with this song. Olorun Oba ma lo pe to si, Olorun Oba ma lo pe yeju. Fun gbogbo ohun to se fun Alafara, Oba Oluwa dakun bo pe mi, Oba Oluwa dakun bo pe awa. Thank you very much.
listen to the Honorable Intellect of the Series of the Inaugural Lecture of the Peace of the Please be seated and let's listen to this. Here is the announcement. Immediately after that, there's a cocktail in honor of the Inaugural Lecture. Thank you. Well, I'm so impressed that apart from knowing chemistry, Professor Olava can also sing well. And for those of you who don't know how to be nice to your spouse is your girlfriend. Alright. I'm glad that Professor Olava took his time to thank most of you for being here. Our equally want to do the same. Some names must be mentioned as we always do traditionally, so I'll go through the list very fast. Of course, he has appreciated the representation by the Excellency, the Governor of State, Malam Abdulrahman Abdulrazak, and he also recognized the representation of the Royal Highness Ashel, the Enemy of the Lord. Thank you. Also recognize this representation of our Senator Gbemisola Rukaya Saraki, the supervisor of most of the training he had in chemistry department, Professor F. Adekola, representative of Honorable Minister of Solid Minerals Development, representative of Honorable Minister of Mines and Steel Development, Professor H.D. Ibrahim, Professor Gani Ambali, Professor M. Akoji, Professor M. Makobi, V.C. Alikma, represented by Professor Lagneji, Engineer Suleiman Yayala Kansuka, Mr. I.O. Adeomi, Madam Sanusi Sule, Dr. Kamal Yusuf. I have a long list to go, so let me sit down, please. Thank you, Mr. Ayalade, Dr. Engineer Abdul Ota, Professor Eji Akalabi, Professor Ms. Medina Salman, Professor R.B. Bale, Professor S. Kuranga, Professor Q. Ade Giram, Professor Eji Yusuf, Dr. Abdulrazak Elias, Professor S. Bambali, Professor A.S. Abdusalam, Professor M. O. Ibrahim, Alaja and Alaja Ibrahim, Kwatunde, Kobio, Alaji Agumomi Deji Imam, Alaji Moru, Aladimeji Ade Shina, TSP Abdullahi Alafiki Belu, Alaji Shakir Muhammad, Dr. Adio S. Wahab, Engineer Dr. J. M. Abdul, Dr. M. D. Ibrahim, Dr. S. Adeni, Professor Ibrahim Yusuf, Alaji Ali Oba Uthman, Alaji Abdugani Isiak, Malam Surajuddin Aitagbe, Alaji Abe Lawa, Engineer Mrs. Abdulrazak Jima, Dr. Ari Odola, Ambassador Yaya Seriki, BC Martin University of Shoko, Federation of Muslim Women Association, Conward, followed by Jikobi of Ilorin, followed by Fulani of Ilorin, Alaji Adiol Salim Alafara, Alaji Abuai Aliyu Alima, Alihaji Musa Mbaka Kabata. The pressure will be placed as still have about 30 to go. Sheikh Abumumi Anaki Ayara, Alaji Sheikh Mekulai Ali, Sheikh Abubaka, Professor Ayo Abimbala, Professor Yes Olondani, Inoka Lecturer, oh, the teacher of primary school, Alaji Ibrahim, Alaji Salim Albarika, Alaja Silifa Ishala, and Mr. C.I. Ozobi. Thank you. And then, College of Education Teachers, Dr. Ms. E. Balogun, Mr. S.S. Sogoyomi, Professor Adelike Ladigi, Professor Ms. E.U. Ikoria, Professor M.M. Jendu, the Minerals, Metals and Materials Society, members, the members of Moro Group, members of Nakomio Para Chapter, Mount Carmel Old Boys Association, principal staff, students of Mount Carmel College Ilorin, principal staff, students of Minaret Islamic Academy Tank and Ilorin, Chairman Alore Central Development Association and his team, Ogidi Ward Unified Youth Council, Habib Rahman Society of Nigeria, Akajola Family of Ilorin, Oga G. Aweri, thank you. Okaka Family of Ilorin, Aderoju Lajunda Crescent Community, Baja to Islam Society of Nigeria, Alafara Family, Alaji Baba Buhari Alafara, Inaugural Lecturers Kigret, Taufikat, Rivanullah, Aminullah, Alima, and Mohamed Nasir Alafara, Inaugural Lecturers Wife, Alhaja Mariam Abdullah Alafara, the good girl, the professor. Mala Kayode Sadiq Toyin, Alhaji Abdullahi Ambali, former Registrar of Kora State. The principal officers, you are welcome and appreciated, provost, deans, and of course, our Unilorin scholars. Thank you all for being with us.
Shall we arise for the University of Ireland?
Vice-Chancellor, please, nobody should come in between, to be followed by the university scholars. The Vice-Chancellor is paying homage to the representative of His Royal Highness, the Emir of Ilorin, the Haji, but the Vice Chancellor.